the law and the grace. So we have seen even in Deuteronomy 4:15, we already saw that the law was written on the stones. He declared to you his covenant, the 10 commandments which he commanded to you to follow, and then wrote them onto the stone of tablets. So we know that the law was written on the tablets, right? On the stones. And Leviticus 19:2, speak to the entire assembly of Israel and say to them, be holy because I, the Lord God, am holy. So the law is calling the people to be holy. The law is making people to be holy. Means through the flesh. Through the flesh. Through the flesh, it is telling you need to make every effort from your mind. I should not do this. I should not do this. I should not commit murder. I should not commit adultery. I should not have any pride. I should not have any anger. All this is through the mind, through the flesh. But does the flesh has the power to withstand the Adam's nature which is within you? The law is written on the stones. It is an external entity. How can it help you? You are an unworthy person. You yourself are a weak person. You are battling in the sin in your temptations day to day. When the Satan can try to tempt to Jesus being God himself, though Jesus did not yield to the sin, though Satan tried to tempt Jesus Christ, who are we the man? Can we not be tempted by the flesh? If there is no grace and if there is no the manifestation of Jesus Christ and the belief and the Holy Spirit embedded in you as part of the born again experience and as part of the regeneration, if these are not part of you, as part of the Old Testament, do you think the flesh can substantiate and try to follow the law? Because the law was not written on the heart. The law was written on the stone. That is the reason the law was weak. We saw in the scriptures, right? The law was weak. God's plan to put the law was weak because he wanted to give that glory, honor, praise and worship to his son. If the law was able to redeem the people from the sin, there was no need for Jesus to come as the savior. Because God's plan of redemption was in Christ Jesus, he has put the law, which is very weak. It is intentional. God is omniscient. God knows that his plan of redemption is in Christ Jesus. We saw in Hebrews 10, 1-4, right? The law is shadow of the things which is yet to come. Jesus being the actual substance, the actual solution, the actual meat of salvation is put in Lord Jesus Christ. That is the reason the law was made very weak. The law was intentionally written on the stones for the same reason. But if you see the grace, the law is written into the hearts of the person. Hebrews 10:16. This is the covenant I will make with them. After that time, says the Lord, I will put my laws in their heart and I will write them on their minds. Who is doing it here in the grace? In the grace, it is God who is doing it. God is putting as part of the regeneration experience. As part of the regeneration, the doctrine of regeneration, a person who is not a saved person, when someone goes and tries to tell the gospel, we saw in the case of the Lydia, God opens the heart of Lydia so that the gospel is heeded into her heart. The gospel is the power of God. The gospel is the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. Gospel is nothing but the regeneration seed, which is put in the hearts of the people in the new covenant, which is in the grace. What about in the law? It is written on the stone. because it is in the written on the stone, it had no ability, because the stone is an external entity, not part of any human being. The law couldn't transform the heart of the person, but because the law of God, the covenant, the new covenant of God is written into the hearts of the mankind, the regeneration seed, the word of God, the gospel, it is going to transform the heart of a person into Christ-likeness. Because the law of God, because the teachings of God, because the gospel of God, because the regeneration seed is put in your heart, you are automatically going to be obedient to the law of God, where you are taking the grace of God into help, you are taking Jesus Christ help, you are taking the help of Holy Spirit in order to be obedient not only to the Ten Commandments of the Old Testament, but even beyond that. So it is because of the God's ability in you, you are obedient to the God's law. So now, do you need to follow Ten Commandments by the flesh? No, but because you are rooted in Christ, because you are a saved person, because you are a born again person, because there is a spiritual seed in you, you tend to automatically try to be obedient to His laws and decrees which He has taught. Example, Great Commission. Jesus told, go to all the nations, preach the gospel, and whoever believes in you, baptize him in the name of Father, Son and Holy Spirit. Now, not only the Ten Commandments, you have several commandments. Love one another. If you claim to know God and if you don't love your brother, then you do not know God. That is also a command. In Old Testament, there are only Ten Commandments which you are asked to follow by the law. But in the New Covenant, it is all about the teachings, what Jesus has taught. What is the purpose of Holy Spirit? John 14. The purpose of Holy Spirit is to remind you of all the teachings what Jesus has taught. Right? So the Holy Spirit is going to teach you all the things what Jesus has taught, so that you tend to be obedient to the law of God. John 14 also says, if you claim to love God, then God says, follow my commandments. Follow my commandments. If you say you love Jesus Christ, then follow all the commandments what Jesus has told in the new covenant. You cannot do this by your sinful nature which is within you. That is the reason God has put His spiritual seed, which is the born again experience in your heart, which is nothing but the law of God, which will make you to be obedient to God's law. Philippians 2:13 also. For it is God who works in you to will and to act in order to fulfill His purposes. So, how are you able to follow the commandments of God in New Covenant? It is God who is working in you. Philippians 2:13. Right? Hebrews 10:16. It is God who is working in you to be obedient to the law, of God. So, Galatians 5:1. Yeah, so very wonderfully, Galatians 5 and Galatians 3, I want you to just spend time during this week to study these. You will understand the elevation, the glory of God in terms of the grace against the law. It is freedom that Christ has set us free. So, we are set free from all the law of sermonical laws, moral laws, civil laws, everything we are set free in Christ Jesus. There is freedom in Christ Jesus, guys. Come on. Don't have the yoke and the slavery that, I need to follow 10 commandments. I failed to follow 10 commandments. I did not follow the Sabbath. Are they not demeaning the deity of Christ? Are they not demeaning the grace of God? We will see through the scripture now. You see what Paul very firmly and very strongly he writes in Galatians 5. It is freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then and do not let yourself be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. Means, don't feel burdensome to follow the law. When you try to follow the law from your mind, you will try to find it difficult. But because God has already given you the Holy Spirit, God has already given Jesus Christ as the manifestation of grace, why are you feeling the burden again? That is what Paul is telling. Mark my words, Paul tell you that if you let yourself be circumcised, Christ will be of no value to you at all. There was the concept of circumcision in the old covenant, and now after Jesus Christ coming also, if you guys, Galatians church, if you guys are still telling that the circumcision need to be followed, then you are insulting the grace of God. That is what Paul is writing. Christ will be of no value. Christ will be of no value, guys, if you follow the law again through your mind. Don't feel burdened. Don't feel that I need to follow 10 commandments. Don't have that burden in your heart. God, it is through the God's ability. It is through your prayer. It is through your personal prayer. It is through your relationship with God. It is through your personal relationship with God. It is through the word of God. You will be obedient to the law of God. You will be obedient to His commandments by the Spirit, not by your ability, guys. Only 2 points what I am trying to tell is, don't try to follow the law from your mind, but try to have a relationship and fellowship with God by spending more time in prayer and the word of God, that you tend to automatically be obedient to God because you already have fellowship with God, because you already have relationship with God. You became God's family, that automatically through the Spirit which is within you, you tend to be obedient to His commandments. Again, I declare to every man who lets himself be circumcised. So here take circumcision as an example, but you can, instead of circumcised, you can put as law. Any person who is following the law, that he is obligated to obey the law. You who are trying to be justified by the law have been alienated from Christ. You have fallen away from grace. Now tell me, if we follow the law of God, we have fallen away from the grace of God. For through the Spirit we eagerly await by faith. Means it is through the Spirit which is within you. I said, right? The regeneration seed which is within us. The Holy Spirit which is within us. So through that, for through the Spirit we eagerly await the faith, the righteousness for which we hope. For in Christ Jesus, neither circumcision nor circumcision has any value. The only thing that counts is faith expressed itself through love. Do you see whatever I have been preaching? It is there in the scripture. You don't need any circumcision or uncircumcision the moment you have Jesus Christ in your life. Even Galatians 3 also. How strongly Paul is condemning the people who are following the law. So Vinny, if you understand the background of the Galatians church, actually they received the gospel, and after receiving the gospel again, the Pharisees, Sadducees and all these people came. They were telling, okay guys, we understand you are accepting Christ, you accepted the gospel, that is fine, but the gospel is not sufficient, you still need to follow the law. So you also need to get circumcised. That is what the Jewish people were coming and telling again to the people who are following the gospel. Some people who accepted the Christ and became Christians from the Jewish in the Galatians church, again there were some people who are coming and deceiving the Galatians church. That is the background of the Galatians book for Paul to write the Galatians letter, this entire book to the Galatians church. This entire Galatians is very powerful to understand the law and grace. So let us see Galatians 3. You foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? Means who deceived you, guys? before your very eyes, Jesus Christ was very clearly portrayed as crucified. I would like to learn just one thing from you. Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law or by believing what you have heard? Means, Paul is asking the Galatians church, did you receive the Holy Spirit by the works of the law or by listening the gospel? I'm not telling you guys, open the scripture and see it, I'm telling you. I would like to learn just one thing from you. Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law or by believing what you heard? What you heard is what? The gospel. I've been telling you, gospel is the power of God. It is the regeneration seed. Okay, let me move further. Are you so foolish after beginning by means of the Spirit? Are you now trying to finish by means of the flesh? Very important for you all to understand. Please digest. Law is to be followed by the flesh. Grace is followed by the Spirit. That is what Paul is trying to tell in verse 3. Okay? Are you foolish? Are you so foolish after beginning by means of the Spirit? Means after receiving the gospel. After receiving the gospel, which is Jesus' death and resurrection, which is the manifestation of God's grace, are you now trying to finish things by means of the flesh? Means, are you trying to follow the law again? Okay? Have you experienced so much in vain? It is really was in vain. Hey guys, again if you guys tell that you need to try to attempt to follow the law by the flesh and you want to follow the law of circumcision, then your experience was waste. He's telling your experience is waste. Whatever you learned by seeing, witnessing Jesus Christ live, his crucifixion, everything became waste for you guys if you follow the law. That is what Paul is telling. So again I ask you, He had so much of patience to ask again. So again I ask you, does God give you His Spirit and work miracles among you by the works of the law or by you believing what you have heard? The same thing he's asking. Did you receive the Holy Spirit by doing the good works, by following the law or by believing in the atoning sacrifice of the Lord Jesus Christ? Okay, so let us go further. Verse 6. So also Abraham believed in God and it was credited to him as righteousness. Abraham was counted righteous by believing in the coming of the Messiah. Point 7. Understand then that those who have faith are children of Abraham. Scriptures foresaw that God would justify the Gentiles by faith. So how are we saved? By faith. How is the faith coming? By God's grace. By the manifestation of God's grace, who is nothing but the Lord Jesus Christ. He is nothing but the manifestation of God's grace. Scriptures foresaw that God would justify the Gentiles by faith and announce the gospel in advance to Abraham. All nations will be blessed through you. So those who rely on the faith are blessed one with Abraham, the man of faith. So who all are the blessed people? The blessed people are the one who are relying on the faith, the coming of the Messiah. Okay, now you see the next scripture, again a warning. For all who rely on the works of the law are under the curse. The Jewish people who are still following the old covenant. In spite of the grace of God, we follow house dedications, housewarming ceremony. We follow Sabbath. We follow seventh day, ninth day. If someone dies, we follow third day, seventh day, 10 days. giving importance to the days. Housewarming ceremony, you give importance to the milk. Marriage ceremony, you give importance to the playing with turmeric. There is no concept of holy days. There is no concept of special days. There is no concept of you can have a housewarming ceremony, but the objective of the ceremony is to glorify God and the opportunity for gospel. Christ is of no value, guys, if you still follow the law. So don't try to follow whatever is written in the Leviticus. That is for the old covenant people. That was only for Israel people. The law was only until Jesus Christ coming. I have shown through the scriptures. Scriptures very clearly have shown you that the law was our guardian only until faith came, which is through our Lord Jesus Christ. The life of a believer is only centered towards Christ and cross. Only Christ and cross. Nothing else. Any opportunity of a function is an opportunity for God, not for your celebration. Marriage. Yes, marriage. You need to have marriage, but the opportunity is gospel. When, yes, you are accomplishing the design of God that you need to get married, but the objective of you getting married is to unite together in the love of God, that you serve as one flesh to God. You are marrying male and female to accomplish God's will, not the will of our individual. We battle, we struggle, try to have a control. Male will try to have a control in his hand, female will try to have a control in her hand. There is a struggle all through the life. Understand, husband and wives, that you two are only one to accomplish God's will. Let me close with the final scripture from the same continuation. For all who rely on the works of the law are under a curse, as it is written, cursed is everyone who does not continue to do everything what's written in the book of the law. Clearly, no one who relies on the law is justified before God, because the righteousness will live by faith. How is the righteousness coming? How is the salvation coming? By faith alone. We know the sola scriptura. Faith alone, grace alone, Christ alone, glory alone. Okay? Verse 12. The law is not based on faith. On the contrary, the person who does these things will live by them. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone who is hung on a pole. So, again, you just see this. The person who does this, the law is not based on the faith. On the contrary, the person who does these things will live by them. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law. We were under the bondage and slavery of the law. Christ has already redeemed you, guys. You don't need to follow the old covenants, Old Testament laws, but you need to depend only on the grace of God, only on the love of God, only the unmerited favor of Lord Jesus Christ. That is, Jesus Christ is sufficient for you. Jesus' grace is sufficient for you. The cross of Christ is sufficient for you. The gospel is sufficient for you, that you no more need to follow any law through the flesh. You tend to follow the law by being obedient to the law of God, by being in the Spirit, by being in the fellowship of God, by being in the grace of God, by repenting in your day-to-day life through the smaller repentance, that you depend on God's grace, you depend on Jesus Christ, you depend on the Holy Spirit, which is spoken in John 15, for your daily sanctification, for your daily holiness. You are no more under the slavery of the law, where you are supposed to follow through the flesh and feel it as a burdensome in your heart. In Christ Jesus, there is freedom, that you just need to depend upon His grace alone.